so I said, take my kids to work. What happens if I sit down and tell the same jokes? Does that make me a sit-down comedian? Alright, now it's time to pull out the big guns. Nah, please don't run, I won't kill you. You ever get that feeling that a super advanced society is just laughing at us? Maybe that explains why socks are always missing. I have a feeling that this society steals our socks just to laugh at us and watch us look for them. I know I had two socks in here. Where'd they go? You ever notice those people that keep a bottle of syrup when it's barely enough to cover one waffle? And there's always room in the fridge. How does this happen? Is this more of that same super advanced society?
Keep it up, it's beautiful.
There you go.
Anyway, it's the old bait and switch. You ever hear the one about the duck and the preacher? I was like, what's a pirate's favorite subject in school?
Arithmetic.
And you ever go to the fast food drive-in and tell them, no pickles, or whatever else you don't want, and then you go home and look at the burger and everything is on it, and you spend more time picking everything off than you do eating it? Yeah, you know, people make a big deal out of everything, such as global warming. Oh, what's up with global warming? What's going on with global warming? You could put an ice cream on the front porch and watch it melt. Why is everyone so concerned about it? We just gotta get a lot more water. We don't need to panic because there's gonna be a lot more water sports. No, I'm so excited, I'm scared. Don't worry, I'll get this feeling unless the doctor says turn your head to cough. I'm just messing around.
What did the cow say to the farmer?
Move to the city.
What's this obsession with cheese? If we take a picture, we say cheese. When something's lame, we call it cheesy. When you have holes in your nose, it looks like Swiss cheese. The power of cheese is very hard for us to reckon with.
I've been trapped in a refrigerator before. One time I was looking for mayonnaise and I was in the fridge for 2 weeks until my loved ones found me. I would have lasted too if I hadn't drink all that Pepsi.
You remember the Rubik's Cube? Anyone says they figured that out's a liar. They probably just rearranged the stickers. I'm Louis Fletcher. Thanks a lot.
Down. I gotta see your crap all day. What do you call this? Comedy? I know mutes tell better jokes than you. And you know, I'm tired of hearing it, and the neighbors are tired of hearing it too. I swear, if I hear any more of that crap, I'm calling the cops. No! You ain't turned shit down. You know what that says? Sergio, you know what that stands for? Kicking your ass! Walk your little bitch ass back there.
Chicken out. Don't buck into the top of the game. Maybe I should quit. People's responses haven't been too good.
Nah, don't.
Nobody thinks I'm funny.
People can't relate to it because it's over their heads.
Well, they'll get it sooner or later.
Oh, they will.
Anything productive happened today?
It's my ex. Trying to make it better.
I think it's good.
Think so?
It's a little out there, but I think it'll catch
up. Hopefully it does. Hey, give us a book. Hi, Spooner.
Hey, am I interrupting something?
Nah, come on in.
How's it going?
Yeah, pretty good.
Have you heard anything about a rash going on or something?
No.
Man, I just came from itching like the dickens.
Really?
Oh, man, I forgot. I got something.
What you got?
Oh, it's tits, man. Oh, it's good. Hey, Mickey.
Hi, Spooner.
No, you should check that out. It looks good, man.
I don't know. What do you think about this, baby?
I don't know,
Spooner. It just doesn't look like me, you know?
Alright, would you rather have to perform in front of people or in front of the garage? I mean, drunk neighbor or your buddy or your girlfriend?
You're right.
No money, no future. Dude, you can be like the next Everybody Loves Raymond and stuff. Have your own show.
That would be nice.
Just I hope it doesn't bomb like Jeff Foxworthy, but man, try it.
Start talking about mama's fat boy, cause your mama is so dumb. Her fat ass thought a quarterback was a refund. Yeah, okay, thanks for being so, such a good audience tonight. Brush your teeth, wash your ass, tip the waitress, and keep on looking out for your boy and mine, Javier Phelan.
Making his debut at the Funny Farm, please give a warm welcome to Boyd Fletcher.
Hey, thanks a lot. And by the way, my name's Lloyd, not Boyd, and I used to live in Alabama, not Gallahama. Okay, that was over everyone's head like a basketball player. I think it might have been above the rim. All right, let me tell you a little bit about myself. I'm a Pisces, so I think I know everything. How many of you guys drive cars here tonight? You ever notice that a gallon of gas costs the same as a gallon of milk? I mean, you think we'd be riding around on cows all day. You know, it's just shave or get a rug. Don't rock the boat or you'll be swimming with sharks. Not many of you sail, I take it. You ever heard the saying, have your cake and eat it too? That's ridiculous. You know, if you had your cake, why wouldn't you eat it? It's like, it's your own cake. You can eat it all you want. How many people buy cakes and don't eat it? When I buy a cake, I eat it.